You are relaxing on the couch and the alarm on the microwave lets you know that your popcorn is ready. You're so hungry that you get up quickly and without paying much attention to your surroundings. And it happens. You hit your leg directly with the corner of a small table. The pain is sharp, although it soon subdues, and you know that you will probably get a bruise there pretty soon. Surely, for most of us, this is a pretty common situation. However, have you ever wondered how is it that bruises actually form tiktakers? A hematoma, more commonly known as a bruise, is a mark which appears on your skin caused by the presence of blood trapped under it. What causes the blood to appear is the rupturing of small blood vessels under the skin. Bruises tend to be painful, especially when touching them, and they can also be slightly swollen. They are usually the product of a hit on the affected part, and most of the time we just have to wait for them to heal over time. They usually disappear in about 2 weeks, although depending on the person, they can last much longer. And during this process, the bruise will gradually change colors. When it first appears, it usually has a reddish or a purplish tone as they reflect the color of your own blood. After a few days, they will adopt a bluish or violet tone, and after 6 days, it will tend to have a more greenish tone. In its last stage, the bruise will have a yellowish color and then it will disappear completely. But be careful, TikTakers! If you see that you get a bruise but you don't remember getting hit with anything, you should see a doctor. Having fragile capillaries in the skin could be a cause, but which factors contribute to them getting weaker? This could happen due to a genetic disorder, old age, being exposed to sunlight too frequently, or taking certain medicines. That said, there are people who can develop a bruise just by the rubbing of their clothes with their skin, which usually happens if you have a low platelet count. You might be familiar with them if you've ever had a blood test. Moreover, hormones can also make bruises easier to form. This can happen when women have premenstrual syndrome or are pregnant. And on the other hand, TikTakers, it has also been demonstrated that intense exercise can make bruises easier to form. We're not talking about normal exercise here, so don't use this as an excuse to never get up from the couch. Just so you get the picture, this is something that usually happens to marathon runners, for instance. They usually get bruises on the back of their feet due to different traumatisms affecting the feet at the same time. Now, the key question is, when should we worry about a bruise and go to the doctor? It is necessary that you see your doctor if a bruise appears on you for no apparent reason and if it's uncommonly big. You should also go if you get a bruise in less common areas like the thorax, the abdomen, or your back. Another red flag is if, in addition to the bruise, you also start bleeding from the nose or gums. In general, hematomas are nothing serious, so most of the time there is no reason to worry about them, TikTakers. However, they can also alert us of other issues affecting our bodies. And like always, you know that healthy eating, physical exercise, and drinking water will help you be much more healthy. See you next time! If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!